Hi, my name is Jim Beckler. Welcome to our website. Hey, I've got a really nice 2013 Solera 24R model. This is built by Forest River. Good company with a good product line. This is built on a Mercedes-Benz Sprinter chassis, so this has really good technology and a nice layout, good combination of drivability and livability on the motorhome like this. That Mercedes chassis has some definite advantages. That six-cylinder diesel engine they put in here is very efficient. The kind of reports that we hear from people that own these are somewhere in the range of between 15 and 17 miles to the gallon. So they get pretty good fuel economy for a motorhome. And they're fun to drive. They're, you know, on a smaller footprint, so you're not trying to find a huge spot to put it when you're out on the road. Very convenient as far as overall handling and drivability. Notice this one does have full body paint too, which is going to add to the, not only does it look nice now, but it'll stay looking better over a period of time too. Your full body paint motorhomes don't have the problem that you'd have with decals over a period of time. Sometimes if the decals will start to peel and fade if it's out in the sun a lot, you know, if you store it outdoors and it gets a lot of exposure to the weather, the decals can start to give you some problem, where full body paint, you're not going to have that issue. Notice it does have a nice step to get up inside the cab. Doors on both sides make it, you know, a lot easier to get in and out. Look down the side here, you can see it does have a nice large awning. That's an electric awning too, by the way, so it goes in and out with just the push of a button. Frameless windows too make it nice, has a nice look to it. A little more flush to the side of your motorhome. Notice nice little storage compartment here. One thing that this motorhome has for this size of a coach, it's got a huge amount of storage. We'll see as we get to the back. It's got a lot of storage. This has got a 110 plug-in here on the side, so if you're out here enjoying the patio side of your coach, you can plug in an appliance or an apparatus. There's your generator. It's 3600 LP generator, so it's propane. Real quiet and efficient. Mentioned more storage. Take a look at that. That's a huge cavity in the back there. It goes all the way across. You can access it from both sides, plus the back has a door so you can get back in there. You can get a lot of stuff back in there. The slide out, this one has two slide outs. The bed slides out the back and then you have a slide out. We'll see a little bit more when we go inside how that works. It's already set up for towing, so you can tow with this. It's got a 5,000 pound hitch and that's about the maximum capacity for towing. There's the other side of that storage compartment. This actually opens up into the same compartment, just kind of comes around and that gives you another area to put things. There's your power cord back in there. Little spot here for a sprayer. You could actually hook up this one does have a little hose sprayer on it, so you take this out if you wanted to spray down. Maybe if you're at the beach and you got a lot of mud or sand on your feet, you could hose off before you go in the coach. Has your water connections here, city and gravity feed for dry camping if you're just going to fill your tank up. Also has a black tank flush. That's really handy, so you can put pressured water to the inside, sprays out the inside of your black tank. And there's a spot to store your sewer hose. And this is going to be your access point for your hookup for your sewer. There's your pulls for your black and gray tank and the hookup where you hook up your sewer hose. One more little compartment over here is going to have, this is where you fill your propane. Again, nice easy access to the driver door. You're going to like the way this motorhome drives. They really are impressive driving machines. That six-cylinder Mercedes turbo diesel performs well, but it's also very fuel efficient. Let's take a look inside. So this one does have the overhead bed, sleeper area, so you can see that makes into a nice big bed. A couple people could sleep up there with no problem. The TV swivels around, so that'll move around. You can flip this back over. When you're traveling, it makes it easier to get in and out of the cab. Speaking of the cab, that's probably, I think, again, one of the most impressive things about this motorhome is the driving capability. Mercedes has it dialed in. You know, their strong point has always been engineering and safety. That's two things that they really strive for in a Mercedes-Benz manufactured vehicle. Speaking of safety, you'd expect to have airbags. Not all motorhomes have driver and passenger side airbags. This one does. It has a driver side and a passenger side airbag. In case of a collision, you do have airbags to help keep you safe. But one of the things that's always impressed me about this chassis is the fact that it has onboard computer sensors, the yaw sensors, to help keep you safe while you're driving it. So it's a way of avoiding an accident rather than give you something that's going to cushion you in an accident. That's a good thing to have, but it's even better if you can avoid an accident and not have to even worry about deploying your airbags. So the reason I mention that is this, it has this ASR system, which will say, for example, you are going around a corner and you're going a little bit too fast and you're actually starting to slide a little bit. You're going outside of the arc of what you are intending to do. So the computer can sense that, so it can determine that your steering wheel is saying you want to go here, but you're actually going outside of that arc. And since this has four-wheel anti-lock brakes, what it'll do is use power to those brakes and to those wheels, to independent wheels, and power to and braking capability to bring you back in line. So in other words, it's by the time you figured out that you're going a little bit too fast and you're going around the corner a little bit too strong, it's already making corrections and bringing you back into play. So Mercedes had that for a lot of years. Most of your passenger cars, all your luxury cars have that feature. I think for the most part, most of your automobiles have that. Those yaw sensors now to help is a great safety feature. This is the only motorhome that I'm aware of that has that feature. So big on safety. That's kind of what you expect from Mercedes-Benz. But it's very user-friendly. Even has a little paddle shifter here, so it's a fully automatic transmission. But if you drop it into drive, it does have a feature where if you want to shift up or down manually, so if you're going up a hill and you want to shift down before you start climbing, you can do that, shift up or down. Very gives you a little bit more control over the vehicle. So there's a couple things on this motorhome. Also, these front seats are going to spin around. So let's see if we can't just show you that real quick. Got this, I'm gonna have to slide it forward just a hair. So I can have that front seat, both front seats are gonna spin around, so you can use that as part of your furniture. So if you had, maybe you have some guests in here, you can have people sitting there. And at your dinette has a nice dinette booth that makes into a bed also. So this will be another sleeper if you needed it. But check out all the storage underneath your dinette. Huge drawers that extend fully. Storage up above also. I really like this little skylight. Actually, it's a pretty good size skylight. But if you, like on a day like today where it's pretty sunny, maybe you're down somewhere where you didn't want to have as much of that sun coming through, you can shut that down. Give you the option of keeping it closed or opening it up. There's a nice little kitchen area. Nice deep sink. Nice residential style faucet with sprayer. Cabinet drawers. Three burner stovetop with an oven also, so you have the gas oven plus the microwave, and they have your fan and everything right here. Nice little drawer here too for pots and pans. Another smaller one down here also, and then nice big compartment underneath the sink. This is handy too, as it gives you a little additional counter space where you need a little more workspace state. You've got it right there. Refrigerators, two doors, so you got freezer up on top, refrigerator down below. Nice, good capacity on that. Looks like it's got all original books with it. That's some storage there. This is handy too. So right kind of midship, you've got your convenience center where you have controls over your slide outs and lighting. It's right in here. Also, your hot water heater you can turn on here. The water pump, you can turn it on here. Your generator starts right here, so you can just fire off that generator. If you want to check your tank levels, you can do that right here. See, you know, how much LP you have, or maybe you know, where you're at on your gray tank, that type of thing. This particular unit's also equipped with an Arctic Pack. So what this will do for you, if you're in some cold weather, you can turn this Arctic Pack feature, put it to use for you. So it's going to help keep your tanks from freezing up. So it's going to give you the ability to be out in some colder weather without having to worry about whether you're going to be down because of a you know, a freeze on everything that you got going on underneath your coach. So if you want to swing around, we can take a look here in the bathroom. It's got the shower and the toilet in here with a nice big medicine cabinet. And you get your sink out here, so if somebody wanted to be brushing their teeth while someone else was in taking a shower, you can do that. Nice queen size bed in the back here. I notice the bed does slide out, so when this comes in, this bed will stack up on top of each other. Makes it nice. So it actually gives you a little bit more overall space in a coach this size. Most of these motorhomes that are built on these Sprinter chassis are not going to be much more than about 24, 25 feet overall. So having the ability to move that bed out gives you just that much more living area. And then you've got some storage space over here with a closet where you can hang clothes and another little drawer down here. The other nice feature on this is the little door back in here that's magnetized, so it's fastened against the wall. If I want to pull this out, I can slide this shut and have a little more privacy in my bedroom area. So if you have guests, they can be using the bathroom and everything, and they're not getting in your way. Also has another little closet right here. So we swing this around, you can see got hanging closet space, quite a bit of area right there. It's good size for this size motorhome. I mean, again, we're talking about a 24-foot motorhome, so you can only do so much with that size coach. But you know, maybe the reason you're looking at a 24-foot motorhome is you go to some places where you don't have a lot of room to park it, so you want something with a smaller footprint, or maybe you're more comfortable driving a shorter coach. A lot of reasons why this could be a really good fit for you. Give me a call if you have other questions. Feel free to get a hold of me. You can reach me on my direct line at 541-510-1017. I'd sure appreciate you getting a hold of me if you have any other questions, or you know, if this isn't the right one. We carry a lot of different units in stock. We generally have somewhere in the neighborhood of around 200 pieces between our towable and our motorized. So good selection, and it's a good place to do business. You know, I like to think I'm a decent guy to work with too. At least I try to be. So give me a call and I'll be glad to help. Again, it's Jim Beckler, and my direct line is 541-510-1017. Thanks.